Dear White People, have you heard of it yet? It is trending high on social media sites with more than 713,000 hits on YouTube alone. This satire explores the issues of race and identity from the viewpoints of four black students at a fictitious, predominantly white school.
Dear White People, breaking news. The amount of black friends required to not seem racist has now been raised to 2. Sorry, your weed man Tyrone does not count. Dear White People, please stop touching my hair. Does this look like a petting zoo to you?
I'm trying to bring a new story to the screen. I'm trying to say something new about the black experience that I don't think is really out there. And, I think it's important. I think it's important for the culture to bring new stories. I do kind of have a problem with the system where only one kind of depiction of black people is out there. I think that we have a lot of stories to tell, and I think our point of view is actually interesting and can be universal.
Well, let's talk about Tyler Perry, because in the trailer, you kind of poke fun at Tyler Perry. What view is Tyler Perry bringing of black America to the masses?
I think that Tyler Perry is bringing a very broad comedic view that appeals to a lot of people. Unfortunately, when I see a Tyler Perry movie, I don't necessarily really see myself on the screen, which was, you know, a major impetus for making this film for me. It's been so validating to me to read the comments on our Indiegogo page, as well as on our YouTube account, the Twitter, the Facebook, all those places. I feel super confident that we're going to get this movie to theaters. There's obviously an audience for it. And I always suspected that to be true, but I really feel like it is. The point of a movie title is to get butts in seats, right? It's supposed to be provocative. It's supposed to be exciting. And the character, Sam White, who starts the radio show Dear White People in the film, she causes quite a stir on her campus. And so, you know, because that is one of the main conflicts that fuels a movie, I just felt it was a great title. I grew up with movies like School Days and Do the Right Thing and Hollywood Shuffle. And, that was kind of like the heyday for me. And I, hopefully this film can be a part of bringing that back.